your fishing. So we're just heading out from Lady Barron now. We're in the polycraft. The boys are just up there having a bit of a land-based crack. Scott and I are very keen. It's probably a little bit blowy, not dangerous, but just probably not very comfortable. Let's do it, Scottish. Flatty in. There's a double hookup.
Maybe I've got in the cap and give me a hand.
Okay, so this flatty should be absolutely knackered by now.
Nice and close and
hook in here. That's not a bad flatty for you, Scotty, is it? That's a double hookup. So we've just pulled this flatty in. We've got this cuttlefish who's made an absolute schmozzle of the boat. Of course, we've been here for, I don't know, 20 minutes, half hour. No action. All of a sudden, bang, bang. And the reason we actually got the cuttlefish, had the squid jig out.
This cuttlefish here, I was struggling with picking him up. It's made
a real mess. The reason we actually were able to get it, we had the squid jig floating out this way, the rod in here, the rod went off, and I actually saw the cuttlefish follow the flathead up, so I got him on the squid jig. So there you go, there's a bit of a nice double up for us.
It's a horse of a flat.
Scotty, what do you got here, matey?
Watch the ink.
Try lifting it, but just lift it up gently. You'll lose it. There's nothing you can do about it.
Nice. There you go.
Very nice. The colour.
How's your colour?
Beautiful.
Made one on too. They're coming on.
It's a nice one, eh? Good to start the night.
Very good size.
Beauty. Alright, that's an ominous start, guys.
First cast, first fish.
Alright, let's plonk it down.
Let's see if you can make it two from two, Ben.
Yep, you gave me the good one.
Yep.
What's he giving you?
Redhead. Redhead. That's the new.
Yeah, come on, Manny.
Let's get this to all.
I think they call that the ghost with the redhead. It's a new colour we just brought out. Oh, wow, well, let's see if we can get it up now. Nice and gentle. Nice and gentle. Hey, look at Scalesy.
Hey.
He's playing the amateur. I'm going to point that at you, mate. That's not
by the tentacles, by the cam,
I'm saying that. Heads up.
Yep.
Ah.
A good little silhouette.
Haven't done a lot of squirting either yet, so watch out. I haven't got him by much. But he's calling out. Heads up, guys. It's pretty elite. Fishing the dive.
Scratchy night after watching the Mundine fight last night, wasn't it?
Oh.
Very tired. Yep. But what are we doing today? I believe we're... What are we doing, Diakes?
I think we're going out pretty wide out in the shell.
Fantastic.
That's trumpeter. So...
Okay, stripe bastard or bastard trumpeter? Which one?
It's a stripey, I think.
Stripey, okay. We've got our captain, Tony, up here. He's taking us out, putting us on the shelf. Benny, you're pretty excited about doing the trumpeter?
Absolutely. I've never been out in the shelf before.
Yeah. Wow, look at these mosquitoes.
Oh, they're pretty bad.
Congregating around Wayno. Called the Barson, sunk in 1912. Let's go and have a look. So this shipwreck's been here for over 100 years. It sunk in 1912. There's not much left of it. We just went up the front. The only bit left that's untouched is the Lone Star Marine winch, anchor winch. Have a look.
Good one, Chris.
She's, have a look at her.
Wow.
A little bit of wood around the window frame. So we've just landed on our whiting spot. We're waiting for the boat to settle. Hey, Benny, you've been pretty excited about this whiting. What's the expectation? What's the first fish we're going to bring up?
Probably a parrotfish, mate.
Parrotfish.
I've been catching with fish.
I'm glad you said parrot and not the other word.
Yeah.
No, looking forward to a big catch.
Absolutely. I think we'll hopefully Tony's put us on the spot and we're going to land some of those big, famous Flinders Island whiting.
Double hook up here on, what do you got? A leather jacket and...
A decent whiting.
Nice.
See that whiting flasher rig there? Coming out of the old mouth of the old Elvis Presley fish.
And,
oh, jeez!
You got a big one, I'll get the net.
No,
that's
more
like
it.
Now
that's more like it. The money.
Chris! That's more like it.
What's the hands?
Rags behind you.
Yep.
You'll grab the rag.
That's massive.
That's rag. They still get bigger.
That's what we came here for.
Ben's done it again.
Look at Benny's scale.
Beauty.
He was excited about the whiting.
What was that rag?
Wow. Here, mate. So, Benny, you were excited about these Flinders Island whiting. What do you reckon of that guy?
Slippery. He's slippery.
We know that.
Here comes another one.
Nah.
Oh, you got off, did it?
Yeah.
Bastard.
What do you reckon of that, Benny?
Oh, that is a thumper. And he's slipping out.
They're very slippery. That's a Flinders Island whiting, buddy. That's what we're telling you about.
Come on, you little baby. That's a nice leathery, too.
There you go. He's giving it a paddle,
one,
eh?
Just, baby.
Yeah.
Take the cover off and see if you can hang on to him.
Is this for comedy value? Because they're quite slimy.
Look at that. Well. All right. Now if we can get it just in the bucket.
Oh yeah.
So far.
Look at that one.
Stumper, Benny.
Look at that one. Beauty.
Pretty happy with that, Ben?
Absolutely. That's what I come for.
Keep it up.
So Tony's going to show us how they catch these crays that Flinders Island is so famous for. So he's got a license for one, so I believe you can't put any more than one in on this particular trip. So what we've done, we've just got some cut up bits of salmon. We've just put it in this little piece in the middle. It's got an Australian salmon that we caught earlier on. Tone's looking for his magic cray honey hole. I'm excited.
That's just a sick one. We're out on the shelf, boys.
Yeah, a little bit of chop. We'll be right.
Just got off the shelf. What are we in, boys? 80 metres?
80 metres.
Wayno, how good's that feeling when you first arrive at your spot, get the first bait in the water?
Absolutely beautiful.
All the boys are rushed for their rods. It's all got very serious. All of a sudden, the frivolity stopped. Everyone just wants to get a line in the water. Actually, something I never do when I'm fighting a fish, sit down. But pretty hard with the waves.
We might have drifted straight off it. Might have drifted off it.
Yeah, I reckon I have.
Yeah.
Not a very wide strip.
Might say our first trumpeter here. We give him plenty.
He was running before, now he's gently coming up.
Oh, Jesus.
That's a stripey.
There's a stripey.
Yeah.
We got a net. There he is, guys. We got the first stripey of the day.
It's worth the wait, boys.
Should be a couple of kilos, I'd say.
Yeah. I've got a feeling I've got something.
Malky's getting it. First trumpeter for the day, ladies and gentlemen. Have a look at that guy.
Beautiful.
On your mounts.
Yeah.
Yep. It's not a bad trumpeter, geez. They certainly, you certainly know when you've got them on. Not a different sort of fight. Because we're fishing in close to 80 metres, I've really had to work to get him up. So, yeah, that'd be a couple of kilo, wouldn't it, Tone?
That's
so I'm just going to put him down.
You got some head shakes there, Mal?
Yes, I do. Something good. It's a good fish.
Nice big snapper.
You like when you got some colour, mate?
It'll be a while.
Here it comes, whatever it is. You got a fair bit of line there. You better get the net under him.
That's a nice one.
We've got three lines here.
Hold the still.
Right for the moment.
Getting followed.
Nah, that's
right. Nice fish.
Oh, that's a better one.
Great fish.
Nah, it's a bubbles.
That's a good one.
Have you guys got something caught over the side? I'm three right now. Oh, good on you, Mel. Thanks, man.
I'll give him a hand.
I think we got the right coordinates, mate. Yeah, we got the right coordinates, mate.
Yeah.
Lovely fish, mate. Absolutely beautiful.
That's beautiful.
They're good eating, yeah?
Nice.
Yeah. Good eating.
Coming over. Well, you got it. Well, don't let him go. Well, you got it.
So we're just coming in to retrieve the cray pot that we put in yesterday. This should be exciting. It'd be good if we can see a cray or two come up. I've never seen them be caught before.
Righty.
Yeah,
Yep.
We got another.
Yeah, it's a carpet shark.
No, we got one grave. Still a three grave in
there. Oh, is that beautiful?
Two in there.
Oh, two.
Fish. Oh, that's a nice one. Never seen them caught before. Apparently very good to eat.
No, they're horrible.
Mate. Horrible to eat, are they, Benny?
You wouldn't want them.
Would you like to find out, or should we try it?
So, Tony, you've done this. You were in the crane game for a lot of years.
Yeah, I was.
Okay.
Probably 40 years.
So, did you say you ran 40 pots?
Yeah, every day.
Wow, okay. You've probably seen a couple of crays in your life.
Just a few, yeah.
Guys, I've got something big here.
Yeah. Hello.
Tom. You got a gummy there, Christopher?
It's not a baby either.
Nice one. Good one.
Hey, there we go, boys. Whoop. There's your run for the day. I've got some colour.
Oh, it's a big slabby, I think. No, it's a gummy. It's a gummy. That's a gummy, or yeah. That's gummy. Nice gummy.
Well, that little. Alright, how long will that be, boys? It's not huge, but it's better than a poke in the eye. Is it 4 kilo? 4 kilo, I don't know, something like that. What do you reckon, Malky? You're more of a sharky man than we are. 5 and 6 kilo. That's a pretty good gummy. I reckon he's all right. All right, I reckon this guy might be going home for dinner because pretty good feed, eh? Let's do our thing. So one has called this one. He's hooked up. It's a big gummy. What do you reckon? 100 kilos? 200? What are we thinking here, Wadey?
I don't know yet.
Just, how's he fighting, bud?
He's fighting all right,
but I've got a lot of weight here.
All right, I'll jump out of your way.
You
might want to grab your rod, Chris.
You want me to grab my...
Oh,
the other one.
Oh, go, go, go. Get it.
Hit him, Chrissy. Hit him.
Hit him.
Hit him, Chris.
Whoa.
Hey.
Yep, it's a double hook up.
Yeah, we'll keep him away from Maud. Here's a big fish.
Oh, yeah. Good chicken mark on
there. Now, boys.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Double hook up on the gummies here, gentlemen.
It's a bit crap, this Flinders Island fishing. You never get any fish.
Look at this. He's just
digging in.
You got him?
Oh!
He's gone. He's a good fish.
What was that, a gummy or a squid?
Yeah, that was a big gummy.
That's a little one, he's just tail wrapped.
Did the gap keep going up?
Ah, right. Look at
gummy,
Graham.
No,
he just wrapped himself up, hasn't he?
Oh, no, he's in. He's in.
Right, what are we going to do with this little bloke?
Boys, you're on.
Yeah, you're on.
Wind.
Bring it around this
spray if you can.
No, tundra.
Go around the motor, that way you stretch your rod out.
Well, mate, we were thinking Ray for a bit there because it was behaving a little bit differently to a gummy. Just went down, held its position. We all come over and we said, oh, mate, you got a Ray, you got a Ray. But it behaved a little bit different in the end, didn't it?
Yeah, it was pretty full on, actually. They seem to fight differently. Maybe it's the area we're in.
Yeah, could be. But, yeah, it sort of felt like it was stuck on the bottom like a Ray, didn't it? And good old Wayno was coaching him, showing him how to get it up, and he certainly got it up.
Wayno did a great job gaffing it as well.
Absolutely, absolutely. Well done, Paulie. Mate, this has got to be the money shot of our Flinders Island trip. This, well, we've got some scales somewhere, but all estimates are around about 20 kilos. So I don't even have any words to say for this.
It's a beauty.
It's a ripper. Gummy going home for everyone. Very good.